Say it loud, M, I'm getting, I'm proud. Say it loud, M, I'm getting, I'm proud. Say it loud, I'm getting, I'm proud. L, say it loud, M, I'm getting, I'm proud. Say it loud, I'm getting, I'm proud. Say it loud, L, give it up for Frank, y'all. I'm getting, I'm proud. L, Frank Ocean, this is your coming out party, baby. I'm getting, I'm proud. All right, you guys, let this rock. Frank Ocean, baby. Ew, can I get a waka waka? Can I get a waka waka? Can I get a ooh ooh? Can I get a ooh ooh? Can I get a how you doing? Can I get a how you doing? Can I get a Can I get a All right. Oh my God, so much to talk about. I had to bring Chingy back just for this show, just for this episode, okay? After the show, you can go mess with the trannies again. You know, I had to bring him back because it's for Frank Ocean. So Chingy's here, Spadison is here, you guys are here, and you're checking out the Bimbo Winehouse Addiction show. So say it loud, gay and proud, baby, honey. I'm gay and proud, honey. So, so much to talk about, you guys. I know I've been gone. Oh God, I hate. And the problem is, when you're gone for so long, so much gossip has happened that you wanted to talk about, and you don't want to talk about it now because it's like old news. Like, you know, once news is over, it's over. So, so much. But big topic, still a topic, is Frank Ocean. As you guys know, he came out the closet last week, admitting that he's bisexual. And don't you just hate that when gay guys just want to say they're bisexual just to make it seem like they're more of a man? You know, they still mess with coochie. Let me tell you something, you gay men, you bisexual men out there. You know you well in a late night, honey. You horny. You got a dick and you got a pussy. I guarantee you, you're going to take that dick, honey, okay? Don't try to I'm bisexual. I believe in bisexuality. But some of you all came to I'm bisexual. You know, like some of you females, you know you take the pussy over the dick, honey. And all you gay guys, you know you take that dick over that pussy, honey. Don't sit here saying you're bisexual, honey. Okay, I believe in bisexuality. Like, I believe some people are attracted to both genders. Yeah, like I thought I was bisexual one time because I used to find some females attractive. I used to like, yo, she pretty, yo. But in reality, I didn't want none of that coochie, honey. Okay, I wanted to be her, honey. Okay, I wanted that hair, honey. Okay, that's why I introduced you all to D, honey. Now I can be that chick I love, honey. I don't want none of that pussy. But I do believe there are some men who are generally, attracted to both sexes. So, you know, and I believe there are some people who are straight gay. Like, I was born gay. I don't care what you say. No. I was born gay, honey. Like, I put on my Facebook, I was brought up to, like, I was taught that I had to like women. Like, I had to like females. Like, that was just the right thing to do. So, as growing up, I just thought I liked females. And I'm like, I don't like this. Like, I don't want this. So by like 7th grade, it was this guy named Robbie. Oh, this dude named Robbie. We used to wrestle. He sat me in a headlock. I used to just, hold me, baby. I was on the download this, so he don't know what the hell was going on. But he used to hold me, Robbie, Rob. But some of us are like really born gay. Like, I was born this way. I will never be attracted to no nasty, fishy pussy, honey. Okay, I don't want none of that shit, honey. I don't want it. I don't like it. I don't need it. I want me a big, fat dick, honey. So, shout out to you all who are bisexual. Shout out to you all who are straight. Shout out to you all who are gay and you know you was gay. You would never be attracted to the other. You can't. I just don't know. So I don't know, where it happened at, but Honey Bimbo is a queen. Honey Bimbo is gay. Let me tell you something. I have no notes. I haven't prepared nothing. So I'm just going with the flow of this show. So as you see, it's what I'm giving to you. Like, I usually have like what I'm gonna talk about first, second. I'm in a rush, so right now, I'm just giving y'all a show. So just bear with me. Listen, you guys, don't forget this Saturday. A party is going down at Secrets. Some of you all seen a promo video, but it was going down at Secrets. The Bimbo Wine House, Wonka Wonka and Birthday Bash. Sister Patterson will be there. You guys know it's at 525 West 29th Street. I believe it's free before 12. Please get there early. The spot ain't but so big, okay? And I don't need you on that line waiting trying to get in. So I need for you to get there. If you got to get there at 11 o'clock, there's nothing wrong with getting to a club early. Okay, a lot of you all feel like you got to get there by 2, 3 o'clock, I'm out of it, honey. Okay, I got me a hotel room lined up. And it's first come, first serve, honey. I invited about 20 guys to my hotel room. I told them Sunday, you know, around this time, I'm being so-and-so place. And you know, whoever get there first, baby, you know, is going to have the goods, okay? Or you others, you might have to wait outside, baby. But it's first come, first serve. I don't do these threesomes. So it's going to be one, you know, one person. So first come, first serve. Come get these goods, baby. Get them while it's hot, honey. But can you produce when you're drunk? Like, can you be sexually active when you're drunk? Like, I don't know. One time I got real drunk and I was trying to like jerk. I just couldn't come. I don't know. Can you come when you're like really like drunk or high? Some people say that helps. Like, I don't know. I like to be slightly sober when I'm having sex because I don't know. When I'm really intoxicated, I really just like I'm like, oh. Let me just go to sleep. So I'm not gonna be too drunk Sunday because I plan to give me some birthday sex, honey. I want my toes sucked, ass lick, dick suck, underarms. I want it all, baby. I'm just gonna lay there like the king, queen I am. D will be there, honey. I don't know what I'm wearing yet. I might wear the bodysuit that Beyonce wore and single ladies, that little, you know, cat suit. And I ain't tucking nothing, honey. Dick gonna be out like what? Okay, I'm wearing heels. I might do my hair blow. I don't know. You gotta be there to see it. Don't forget Saturday, baby. Get there early because the spot ain't but so big. I'm telling you, motherfuckers gotta be in there, honey. So I see you all. But, I don't know. Back to Frank Ocean. You know, I think that was a huge step for, like, an R&B artist. Male artists to come out the closet, and it's a lot of, you know, gay artists, but they're not mainstream. Like Frank Ocean is in the mainstream. Like he's out there with the Neos, the Trey Songz, the Ushers. So for him to come out and admit that he's bisexual, I really have to applaud him. A lot of people thought it was a fraud. You know, it was a way of publicity. Hell, if it is, it's work. You guys know, people, you ain't nobody until you're dead. One. Or you put out a sex tape, or you come out the closet. So for him to come out the closet, and a lot of people say he's just using this for his album sales. And then you're damn right. I want to use it for my album sales too. I ain't gonna just come out the closet and let you know I'm coming out the closet, honey. There's a reason behind this, honey. I got a new album coming out. I'm gay. I like to suck dick. I like to get my dick sucked by dudes. Now go buy this album, honey. I never really found him attractive, but you know what? Looking back, Sister Patterson, Chingy, we were talking about this. Like that song he had, Novocaine. If you get into them words, honey, them words are a little hoo-hoo. Listen what he said. Novocaine, baby. Fuck me good. Fuck me numb. Fuck me hard. Yes, go look up the lyrics, honey. I don't know if that's the... But it's certain round of words. So what we can tell from Frank Ocean is that he's a bottom, honey, okay? He wants you to fuck him good, fuck him now, fuck him hard, honey. He like to take that dick deep in his ass, baby. So, I mean, I really don't have no big thing about Frank. I mean, congratulations. I'm just waiting for the rest of you motherfuckers to come out the closet. I ain't gonna say no names, honey, because I ain't want to gossip, honey. But, you know, if you watch it, you know, a few of you, you know, a little... Okay, but Trey Songz, if he was gay, he could never come out the closet because to me, his 90% of his fans and supporters are females. Like Trey Songz is a sex symbol. You know how many bitches' heart he would break if he was to come out the closet and say that he's been fucking Brandon Hines back in 2000 before he got famous. Sonny, I ain't saying that because I ain't want to gossip. But a lot of bitches, huh? But then again, a lot of you bitches out there, you deal with these gay men, you don't give a fuck. As long as you fuck you good, look good, ass good, dick good, you're gonna continue to fuck them. As long as he ain't no woo-hoo. you know, he could just be a regular, like, for a lot of people say they look at Frank Ocean and they can't tell that he's gay. You stupid meatballs, there is no look to gay. Like, you can look at me and tell I'm gay, because I don't front. I like for you to, I want you to know I'm gay. I mean, I'm not fronting for nobody. And that's another thing. I applaud Frank, because all of us ain't trying to be in nobody's closet, okay? There are some people like me who like to let the world know who we really are, okay? I was not happy being in nobody's closet. I was uncomfortable, and then I just didn't feel right. I mean, applaud to you all out there who watch this show. You live in the closet. You know, toodles to you, baby. But big people like me, Frank Ocean, people like others, and Perez Hilton, and you know, all the other queens that come out, B. Scott, we don't want to be in nobody's closet, honey, okay? We want to let you all know what it really is. So I applaud Frank, but shout out to all you little down low closet men. If you happy with that, having a wife, kids, but doing your little dang on the side, that makes you more power to you. But people like me, I'm gonna keep it real with you. And I would also want to shout out to a little Scrappy, because a lot of celebs, that's enough. I just don't know why must it be a big thing when somebody let the world know that they're gay. Like, what is the problem? I'm equating to the damn Bible, because you always talk about gays as sin. So abortions is sin. Like, I hate to always bring this up on the show, because y'all people, y'all just go so hard on gays for no reason. We are regular human beings. Just because we like to sleep with the same sex, that is our motherfucking business, okay? But you all feel like, oh, we going to hell and this, that, fuck you, you going to hell, bitch, because you're judging. Isn't that something in the Bible? You shouldn't judge others. But we're not going to make this a Bible show, honey, okay? But I will say this, what was I saying? Oh, hell, I don't know. I told you, this show is going everywhere. I'm just so happy to be doing this again. You guys, don't forget Saturday, we're going to dip it low at Secrets, baby. So what do you all think about Frank coming out the closet? Neo had something to say. Neo was on Power 106, and they asked him about Frank Ocean. This is what Neo had to say. To each his own. If that's how he rock, you know that's how he rock. You know what I mean? It don't change the fact that his music is incredible. It didn't change the fact that he's an incredible artist. He chose to put his personal life out there, and that's him. So what, Neo? You would have kept it a secret? You keep it a secret if you gave? That's what you saying, Neo? That's what you saying? I don't fault people for who they are. If that's really who you are, you know what I mean. If that's really who, I'm not gonna judge you behind that. That's not my place. So you keeping your little situation secret. You keeping it personal, right? Like I said, some people like to come out with it. And some of us, I ain't saying nothing. And then they asked Neo about his gay rumors. Oh, excuse me. He said, "Call me ugly or something." Let's think of something else. Yeah, Neo, because you ugly. You ain't gonna alibi Neo because you ugly. The whole gay thing has been around for a little too long. Say I'm adopted. I'll take the Ninja Turtle comments, but I'm tired of the whole gay thing and blase, blase, blah. I don't know. Do you all think Neo's gay? I don't know. I'm so over Neo. I don't care. Neo was gay. He ain't my type anyway. Like, if you was to come out the closet, I wouldn't not care because I don't want you, okay? All right, and I got a quick email about somebody was talking about the whole, wait, where's it at? Give me a second, you guys. She was talking about the whole him coming out the closet, Frank Ocean. So let me just read this quick email. Hey Bimbo, Waka Waka and it's T. So I went on Twitter today and remember why I just got back into it. I had two debates. One was about gays and others was about the black versus white. Is this the email on it? Oh yeah, yeah. The one dude said that it's over for Frank Ocean because he's gay, which is too ignorant for me because his female fans, male fans who are comfortable with their sexuality and the LGBT community will definitely support him. Combine that with the endorsements he will get and that equals money. Also, these straight guys who are so homophobic, but they be wearing Gucci, Louis Vuitton, Prada, Hermes, Fendi. Don't they know these designers are gay? Everyone knows that gay men dress better than everybody. Also, the same person said that they mad because the BET Awards were so racist and don't cater to whites. And blacks are the reason for racism. So why are the Academy Awards and Country Awards for? Not us. They complain about every dang like they didn't start this racism shit. At least back then. Oh girl, what are you talking about? I should have had the crickets playing. Whatever. I mean, you all gonna have your different opinions about Frank Ocean, but I'm just glad that he came out. Like, he's free. Like, you can be yourself now. You ain't gotta hide, fronting no more. And then Lil Scrappy made a comment about, what was it? He also applauded him for coming out because it be the down low dudes that spread the AIDS. Let me just say something. AIDS is spreaded from everyone, okay? It's not just a gay thing or a man thing or a black thing. AIDS is everyone, okay? So that whole, but I do disagree with men who are like down low and you fucking with men, and then you got a wife at home and you know you've been dipping in this boy ass raw, and then you go home and fuck her raw. Okay, if you're gonna go out and cheat on her, at least have some type of audacity to either use a condom or him or use a condom or her. Like, you just slinging your dick all around. So I agree with Lil Scrappy on that. Yes, some type of download, man. But let me explain something. Gay is every day. You can have two out-the-closet gay boys who are fucking and raw. So, no. Gay is everyone. Only way you gotta protect yourself. That is it. Protect yourself. Stop worrying about everybody. Protect yourself. If you're gonna give it up or do something, protect yourself, baby. And condoms feel alright, I guess. Okay. I got. Shout out to everybody who uses condoms. Condoms is like, it feels good after a while. But yeah, protect yourself. So it's not a gay thing. AIDS thing is not a gay thing. It's just a thing, period. Anyway, like, again, what do you all think about this whole Frank Ocean thing? Like I said, I'm happy that he came out. Woo woo. Move on. Okay, hopefully your album sell. And if you are lying about you being gay, Frank Ocean, like, shame on you. Like, how dare you use someone else's lifestyle to get, okay. You know what? I ain't gonna hit on your house, baby. You gotta do what you gotta do, baby. But I need to see you kissing a man or something. I need some more facts. I wanna see you kissing Tyler the Creator. I wanna see you kissing Kanye. You better kiss someone. I wanna see what your boo look like. Alright, so what do you all think? Anyway, we're gonna move on. Like I said, we're just going with the flow of the show. Remember, this Saturday, baby, the Waka Waka Am. And I also heard that Target is not carrying Frank Ocean new album, Orange. Well, a spokesperson for Target said that they are not carrying the album because his album went digital. So, I don't know. I'm not buying it. I was never a fan of Frank Ocean. I just like that song, Novocaine, baby. All right, so moving on, you guys. The BET Awards. Lord, catch the BET Awards. I didn't watch. You guys know I don't watch TV. But I will say the Whitney tribute was a hot mess. I'm sorry, all you know. No, I call it how I see it, baby. Sissy Houston, that's Whitney's mother. I love you, you know. But you need to sit down. You should have had Aretha Franklin, somebody who really sing, come out there and sing. I know what you're trying to give and do, show love to your daughter. But honey, them notes was just who, okay? You should have had Aretha Franklin sing. You should just do a little speech or something. You know, do a little something. And then Brandy, was you out there giving a tribute to Whitney Houston or Michael Jackson? I've never seen Whitney do all this dancing. And then Monica did a good job, but I just think she should have done another song. Like, we didn't need two gospel songs. If Sissy was gonna do a gospel song, you should have did one of her other songs. I don't know. You could have did I Will Always Love You. I didn't want to. Jesus loves me. We didn't need all that. It was too much church, baby. And then Chaka Khan, baby, I can't wait to talk. Then Chaka Khan looked like she ain't give a fuck about nobody's Whitney. She was out there flaunting her new weight loss. I'm every woman, honey, okay? I look good. Fuck you, Whitney, bitch. She ain't look like she was out there singing. She was out there flaunting her weight loss. What, baby? Get it to me, baby. That tribute was a hot mess. I'm sorry. Only people that could do me justice for a Whitney Houston tribute is Coco from SWV, because she sings, honey. Patti LaBelle, Mariah Carey, Tamaya Mann from the Tyler Perry Place, who don't like me. I don't like you either, Tamaya. She gonna hit me up till I stop emailing her. Well, look here, bitch. Okay, it's always you church people. Anyway, she can do a good job. There's a couple of people, but all you, Brandy, let's sit down, honey, okay? I know you had this little close relationship with her, but honey, you was out there looking like straight up Michael. Oh. What did you all think? And then Soulja Boy crying. I was just like, you know, really, Soulja Boy, what was you thinking about your career being over? He was just, oh. I mean, I guess, you know, CeCe Houston got a couple of people emotional. I mean, I was, you know, I wanted to cry. I felt like I needed to cry because everybody else was crying. But I'm sorry, you all. CeCe, honey. Oh, Girl, what else? Oh, and Kim Kardashian and Kanye West and Beyonce. Kim, you looked so out of place. You should have just stayed home. I would have felt so uncomfortable. And they're like, you there, these motherfuckers made hits. These people had to really, you know, work for something. Work for their fame. Work for, you know. Bitch, all you had to do is throw them legs up. Bam, okay? Suck a little dick and you whack in bed anyway. I would have felt out of place. And I heard Beyonce the one who said next to her like Jay-Z. I don't want that. You guys know, one of my little sources close to Beyonce, I ain't gonna say who, but if you know who I'm talking about, you shouldn't know who I'm talking about though. They told me that Beyonce don't give a damn about nobody's Kim. Hey you all, it's a Bimbo Winehouse, Wonka Wonka Am, and this Saturday, that's right, this Saturday, July 14, 2012, it goes down to Bimbo Winehouse, Wonka Wonka Am birthday bash. It's all going down at the Secret Lounge. Secret Lounge is at 525 West 29th Street between 10th and 11th. That's right, y'all, the Secret Lounge, 525 West 29th Street between 10th and 11th. That's right, make sure you are there early. Doors open at 10 o'clock. That's right, doors open at 10, so make sure you use the first one at the door. Talking about some Wonka Wonka email. That's right, so this Saturday, July 14th, Bimbo Winehouse, aka D Winehouse, because you best believe I will be in drag, honey. I'm celebrating my birthday, my 27th birthday. Damn, 27, I'm getting old, y'all. 27 is like 57 in gay life, right? Yeah. But yeah, this Saturday is all going down at Secret Lounge. I hope to see you all dipping in low with me, talking about Wonka Wonka. Sister Patterson will also be in the building as well. Don't forget, you guys, this Saturday, July 14th, the Bimbo Winehouse, aka D Winehouse, birthday bash at Secret Lounge. See you there.